Detroit. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Dallas Cowboys and the Detroit Lions. 2-1-1 teams here, each looking to move over 500, and we are underway here in week 3. And this will make it into the end zone. Decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Carry for DeAndre Swift. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From the 22, here's second and 8. Now a toss for Swift left side. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Now here's first and 10. They'll drop the throw, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. From the gun, here's Swift. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
He's brought down at the 42-yard line. That's a gain of 8.
They'll try and run here with Swift. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. Defense had a chance to get off the field here in the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
2 first downs, have them up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on 2nd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. first down pickup of 8.
First drive of the game. We did see this in practice, didn't we? Because they allowed us to stay and watch and see what their opening script would be, even though we don't know the exact play calls. That looks a lot like what we saw them execute, doesn't it?
Really does. And in practice, it wasn't about a lot of big shots on that opening drive. They wanted to put together a series of plays, sustain it. They've done that. The defense now on their heels a little.
That they are. And you know what else is happening now? They're gaining information. They're gaining knowledge about how the defense is planning on playing them. So not only are they being successful on this drive, they're filing things away for future drives in this game.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Running is Swift. And he will cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
Brings up third and 2. To throw here. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. TJ Hockenson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions take it right down and score on the opening drive. Now Matt Prater for the point after. It's up, it's good, and the Lions lead 7-0. That's the score, Lions 7, Cowboys nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taken in the end zone. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. There's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. Amari Cooper, his intended receiver, and it's third down.
So many times we see teams go on the road and want to lean on their running game, but this crew just announced they're going to try and air it out and make hay downfield.
They come up now, third and 5, following the incomplete pass. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And that is incomplete.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. 37 yards on the punt with no return. And the Lions. Lions will take over.
First and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give them a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down.
It's second down and 10.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. On the RPO, that's complete right side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. This one to his tight end out on the right side. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 29-yard line. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here. First and 10, it's Swift. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are able to extend their lead.
I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
It's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead.
Lions 14, Cowboys nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded in the end zone. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Prescott from the gun into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33, and the return
stop right around the 25.
They're trying to resurrect his confidence. Last week was a disaster. 5 interceptions in that loss, and another pick there.
I played with a quarterback like this before, and he had a tough game, and the head coach said, I'll take him, I'll fix him. The very next game, he started out the exact same way. The head coach turned to the offense coordinator and said, he's yours from now on. Someone has to take responsibility and work with him and try and get him settled.
And give him about 3 as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
He was taken
down. Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Here's Swift. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on first down.
A 1-yard gain brings up 3rd and 6.
Nothing to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
14. Cowboys nothing.
They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's 3rd and 6. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. This Cowboy defense looked ready for that 3rd down pass. Brings up 4th.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces them to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
At their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ball game as they come up 1st and 10. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, and it's 2nd down.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. They'll run with Elliott. He'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
That was a good run, and it got to the 2nd level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, 1st level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Looking to throw, Prescott. And the throw there going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's 4th down.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
26-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. The quick throw complete into the flat out left. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
The Lions on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 6. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
This is taken at the 23. It'll be a net of 40 yards there following a 43-yard punt, 3-yard return, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
And a Cowboy first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Prescott to throw it. He's going to let this one go deep. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
The scoreboard tells a story for him, a little bit bleak. And while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close. But the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Here's Prescott. This to Jarwin. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And they're left looking at 3rd and 8 after the second down pass play only went for 2. Prescott. And it's caught off the deflection. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Prescott and Lamb hooking up for the Cowboy first.
Now that's the defensive coordinator's nightmare right there. You're covering everyone, and the guy's not even the intended receiver ends up making the play.
Right place, right time, I guess.
When that ball's tipped up in the air like that, you've got to go up and get it. Offense and defense, and in this case, the offense ended up grabbing it.
A first down carry by Elliott. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. They'll give him 1 yard on the play, and it'll give him a fresh set of downs. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting 3rd down so far this year. They're in the bottom 5 in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin, tell us where they rank on 3rd and what, right? I bet they're in the top 5 in the league on 3rd and 5, 3rd and 6, 3rd and 7 or more, because that's how you end up not converting.
Oh, Prescott stripped. We'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And this is incomplete. Blake Jarwin, the intended receiver, and now it's 3rd down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. To throw is Prescott. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. How about that? They weather the storm of a 3rd and 17 to pick up the 1st. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Here's Prescott. That is caught inside the 5. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down. So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, and now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
Now Elliott. Cowboys are going to be set up with a 1st and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1-yard line.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
Will use the 1st of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. It's the fullback. His 1st touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Cowboys cut into that lead. His kick is good.
Makes the score Lions 17, Cowboys 7.
So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away.
Now this will make it into the end zone.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
At their own 17-yard line.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points.
And the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, Detroit.
We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17.
Lions 24, Cowboys 7.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Takes this about 5 yards deep. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
And a first half that really has not been kind to them. A late opportunity here to maybe make some inroads on this deficit before half.
And this drive's going to go a long way towards telling us whether they actually have a chance to come all the way back in this game or not.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
At the 24 yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Elliott. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. Jamie Collins with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven. Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Negates a pretty decent punt return.
And the goal is to gain a first down on a punt return, which is 10 yards. This was much more than that, but it is going to come back due to the illegal block in the back.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. They run out of the gun with Swift. Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the juke. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action.
action in the third quarter.
And this carries into the end zone. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. On first and 10, Prescott. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That's a nice play there.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Prescott off play action. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Jeff Okuda. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They'll start on the ground with Swift. He'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
And he's only able to work this from the 8 to the 10 for a pickup of 2. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And he is going to have the Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Swift. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a 3rd down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
On 3rd down, here comes Swift.
And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
And here now the punter Fox as he sends this one away.
Taking it about the 16. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
At their own 24-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
First down, it's Elliott.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit.
Now Prescott. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. And since they still have 10 yards to go, they'll just say, let's roll this over to third down and decline it.
Let's just be honest about it. If you can't get them off the field on third and 10, then something's wrong with your defense anyway. No sense in taking that penalty.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. Throwing, Prescott. Steps away to his left. He can run for it, and he will.
And he can only get this to the 42-yard line, and that is not near enough.
The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth.
It's now fourth down.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. As he's on here to punt it away. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. Just 21 yards on the punt there. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4 minutes.
And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. Jalen Smith able to get him for a loss of about three.
Like how they started the third quarter here, they force a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. This is Swift on the counter, and not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 15.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On third down, he'll drop to throw.
That's complete to Swift out of the backfield.
And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Hey,
they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. They'll run on first down. Swift. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Tackle there by Leighton Vander Esch. I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Here comes the Lions punter now as he's on to kick it away. This is taken around the 12. A 41-yard punt, 9 on the return.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish. A completion, yes, but certainly not what they wanted. A loss of a full 6 yards. Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And they do finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 41.
A pickup of 44 yards.
Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield.
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. Touchdown, Cowboys!
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was
incredible. It's up and good, so they claw back into it. 24-14 now.
Lions 24, Cowboys 14.
So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away.
This will make it into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
We got him. First and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Now all of a sudden, we've got an interesting game here. You just saw them go down and score a touchdown. And what was a comfortable lead at halftime, it's down to a 2-score game.
And so the obvious thought is they've got to ramp things back up again. Got to get the offense into high gear. But we've seen this before when you've kind of been in shutdown mode for a while thinking that you're okay. It's hard to mash the gas again and have everything work perfectly. They've got to fashion together a good drive right here and now.
Because defensively, got to be feeling confident. They haven't allowed a point this half. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. He throws there, incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Got a his man complete over the middle. It's Banks. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 27 yards there on a very nice third down conversion. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. So that one a disaster, a big loss there with second down coming up. A throw over the middle, take it in. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up the third down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
They'll look to throw again. He's going to air one out. This is caught inside the 15. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He'll get this into the hands of Bird. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Marquez Valdez-Scantling there to make the grab. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
Would be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue
to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. On second down, Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. He went backwards 7 yards, setting up a tough third down. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Prescott now. Oh, Prescott stripped. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And they will take over with a football just outside of the 10 at the 12-yard line. A little careless with a football, and he also had a fumble loss last week, didn't he?
He certainly did, and when I'm watching him play, the one thing that comes to mind is always remember, traffic, turbulence, people around you, two hands. Get two hands on the ball. Grip it tight. I know it looks cool to have it in one hand. Put it away. Tuck it away because you've got to take care of the ball.
First down, Swift, And he'll find his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Once again, it's Swift. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
I have zero rooting interest in either team in this game. I only want a good game. But with all the offense we've seen from them tonight, it's kind of nice to see the defense step up and make a big play.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were ever going to get him in the backfield. Nice to see him get a stop.
On 3rd down, Swift. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
The tackle by Neville Gallimore.
We got him!
No gain on the play.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for Detroit, it's back-to-back victories now after the Week 1 defeat as they move to 2-1. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Chicago Bears next week. Meanwhile, for the Cowboys, they'll fall to 1-2, and they'll get the...
Flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
Flag on the play.
Holla.
There's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown. Scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag. Ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass. Come through stunning. Call me tired, girl, and hit the hole. Then I ran it. Get money. You ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline. A flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons. I just made a play. In the red zone. Going strong. Watch me shaking and bake.
Let's go.
I just took off with that rock. Just like Tyreek Hill. I just count 100 racks. That's a whole. Championship, get them out of here. I just gotta say, like I run up in the backfield. I just gotta say, like I ran up on a quarterback. Shake and bait, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no formers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, 6 rings, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me tired, girl, and hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, you ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I'm in the field like a Panther, I done up the standards. Like Michael Vick in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, how I throw them Ravens across the border.
Hold up. You know I'm a touchdown with the sack. Run up the whole life, run it back on the play. Intercept the pack like a safety, you boys ain't shake the play. That's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me tired, girl, and hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, you ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
Nike check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shawty got a man